Welcome to a new test and teardown video. This time, it's a power supply from Swedish Oltronix. It's actually two different models, but they're very much alike. One is called the B60-1, and the other one is C40-1. So it's 40 volts, 1 amp, and 60 volts, 1 amp. I've been looking a little bit here on the front, and I can't really figure out exactly what it is we're doing with those switches. If we look at that model here, the 40, C40, there is no text indicating what this switch is doing. But it is right next to the amps, so my best guess is this one will short the output, so you can read the current setting. That's just my guess. On the B60, it says set constant current. So I think definitely a short of the output, and then you can set the current. So that is a good idea, right? But look at that one. Voltmeter 14 volts. So what is that? No idea. I don't know how old they are yet, but I'm definitely going to look for identifications inside. If we look at the rear, they're exactly the same, and the same cabinet and all that. And look at that big, nasty power entry. Oh no. But luckily I got exactly the right connector stocked. And this one got ground chassis connection for my protection. So that is good. So I do dare to power this up and see if it works. Let's do the first power up. Mains is applied. Nothing bad happened. Oy, oy, oy. So we got output voltage, bright light, and it is working. 44 volts of output. So all this is really nice. So let's try and push exactly what it's doing. Look at that. It is shorting the output, and then you can, of course, adjust. And I can see, there is a power consumption is 62 watts, and now it is 9 watts. So that is what's happening when you push the set current. Well, that definitely works, so I will now open it and have a look. So let's have a little look inside. I just pulled this card up this socket, and I see two selenium rectifiers, Xeno diodes, and some transistors. I was able to date this to 1972. Not directly because of date codes, but because of those two transistors here. They're called ACY17. So that's a PNP germanium transistor. And that is, I think, first released in 1972. So, I mean, depending on where you seek this, maybe you can come up with something that is better, but that is the only thing that I can actually really use as a date code for this PCB. So 1972 is my best guess so far. The other parts in here is more or less straightforward. I see four power diodes. That's of course the main diodes, and that will charge This capacitor is definitely our main capacitor. We got some power resistors. And that resistor here is in series with the current set switch. So it's not directly shorting the output, but via a resistor. And that is, of course, to prevent the short circuit current from reaching insane values that will break the switch. So that's quite smart. Here we got a driver transistor and a power output transistor. And if you look at this aluminium frame, it's actually the entire frame here in one piece. It is quite thick metal, 3.5 millimeter thick aluminium. And it is bent and touching the entire backside and the front side as well. It goes down there and it's bent up here. And here we go, the output transistor and the driver transistor. So that is how this power supply is made. And if we take it side by side with the 60 volt version, that one was called B60. And I've been Googling a little bit around and looking at some pictures and stuff. And I can also find this one called B40. And then you also find those two buttons also in red on that model. So this one is definitely a lot older. You clearly see it on the meters. But oh, look at this. It's definitely a lot different on the inside. And you can also feel its weight. It's much more heavy. Everything here is bigger and more heavy. The meters, the capacitor, more capacitors, even the transformer is bigger. But of course, 60 volts, 1 amp versus 40 volts, 1 amp. So yeah, it should of course be bigger, but it is also a lot different made. Look at that PCB. This one is from 1965. And this is directly datable by date codes on the two transistors here. 1965, there you have it. And the funny thing here, let's take the two boards side by side. They didn't reinvent the whole thing. No, they just upgraded it a little bit. Isn't that just funny? See? Let me see if I can have it like this, right? See the two bridge rectifiers, set 2 and set 3, they're here as well. Set 2, set 3. And look at the two voltage regulators in the good old days. Yeah, they used tubes. So this one is a 150C4. So this is a 150 volts, 5 to 30 milliamps. I was writing this down here so I could remember this. And the SR5 is 85 volts, 1 to 10 milliamp voltage regulator tubes. So, and remember, D1, D2. Look how funny that is. This is also D1 and D2 here. But now it's 6 volts and 12 volts. And then they, of course, change a little bit in the circuit, but more or less, the circuit is the same. That is really funny. This is the 60 volt version, and I do see a cracked reefer. When don't you see those cracked? A lot of people, they really, really hate reefer capacitors. But I mean, they were of course not designed to last 55, 57 years. I mean, so of course it's okay for the capacitor to fail, but nothing else is, you know, cracked or broken or burned. So that is the weakest part in many, many circuits. Just go for the reefer capacitors. And there's actually another one down there. But I'm going to power this up now, and then we're going to see if it works, the 60 volt version. So now we're going to power this up the first time, and I dimmed the light a little bit on purpose, so hopefully we can see the voltage regulators. Mains is applied, nothing bad happened, and we got light and we got output. Oh yeah, there is a tap switch relay. I did not expect that. I thought it would be an output relay or something like that. Let's crank up the voltage. And then the fine. Ha ha, 60 volts. Oy, 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 oy. This is not at all stable. Is it really that unstable? We're still in the warm-up phase of the regulator tubes. It's getting more and more nice and shiny. And then it is getting more and more steady. Let me try and... So this is 21 watts. And I will take down the output current. And we're going to push this one. Oops, it's still 20 watts. Ah, it's because of the relay. So it's, yeah. And then the amp meter goes up. You should be able to see this if I do like this. Okay, difficult to show. Yes, so that will be the amp meter, and then I can crank up the juice. And then you got a few volts of. Okay, then 60 watts. Okay, so that is definitely due to the amps. But hey, this thing really works. So what is this for? Voltmeter 14 volts. What is the idea? If you know, please tell me. Because, ooh, this meter hammers up, but the output is not. What is the idea? So maybe you turn down voltage to zero. Okay, it goes to zero. And then nothing happens. So what the... Okay, I really don't get it. Something happens. And it says voltmeter 14. Why do you do this to me? I don't understand it. But I am, of course, not so smart. What? Well, well. Okay, and we don't have light in this bulb. So I need to measure what kind of voltage we got here and maybe see if I got any bulbs. So now I put in a new lamp and adjusted the brightness a little bit down. It's actually quite easy. There is a winding for the bulbs. So there's a 7 volt winding. And let me show you where that is. So that is the winding for the bulbs. And I put in 268 ohm resistors in parallel just to spread out the heat a little bit. I couldn't find the right bulb, so I put in a 12 volt bulb, but when I put it all the way into the hole here, it's just way too bright. in the original one, the bolt was sitting a long way from that little tiny hole, so of course it needed to be bright. It was a 7-volt bulb, and it was on 7-volt about 300 milliamps, so that is a crazy amount of power. And I think it's the same thing in this one, and that bulb is also very, very bright. It's almost, it's just way too much. I prefer it to be dim, so you can still see what you're doing, but it's not supposed to eat the lamps. So that's just my take on it anyway. So thank you very much for watching. I don't want to say any more about those nice power supplies here. They are both really cool and good and working. So bye-bye.